Chris Steele, you're headed towards being former speaker, but you're still doing important work on the issue of justice reinvestment. I was in attendance yesterday, along with a few other journalists, watching yesterday for reference of the viewers. It was Thursday and of the 13th of September for the initial meeting of the working group on justice reinvestment. And not to be critical, I had a little bit of a feeling that some aspects of the system might not be ready for this transformational change. Could you talk about that?
Sure. And first of all, I would like to say thank you for the opportunity to discuss where we're at in the implementation phase of the Justice Reinvestment Initiative. I do not think you're being critical. I think you're making an honest observation about sort of where we're at in relation to the actual implementation, which is set to take place November the 1st. It was very obvious with our working group yesterday that we have a lot of work yet to do, particularly within the Department of Corrections and the Department of Mental Health, to really make sure that we are where we need to be in implementing the law that was signed into effect. And so what we've done, and the purpose of the working group, is to foster communication and collaboration and education on where we're at so that we can make sure and pull together and work together to make sure that the Justice Reinvestment Initiative is indeed successful.
Would you anticipate that a line worker or the director of corrections and also mental health agency will be there in October?
I sure hope so. I will tell you that I've had direct communication with both Director Jones and Commissioner White, Director Jones being in charge of the Department of Corrections and Commissioner White being in charge of the Department of Mental Health and Substance Abuse Agency. And they are both working diligently and working hard to make sure that implementation occurs in the manner in which it's supposed to occur. I would also, to be fair, point out that I don't think that everything has to be implemented all at once come November the 1st, but I do think that we're going to have to be ready to implement key parts of the law. That's what we're required to do. And I'm pleased with their commitment. I'm pleased with their individual progress. But it's very clear that we've got a lot of work to do yet together and in a collective sort of way.
30 seconds or so, the rationale behind this legislation, which I've covered extensively, but let's assume someone wants a three-sentence summary of why this is important to Oklahoma.
Justice reinvestment is important to Oklahoma because it's going to allow us to reevaluate how we're currently expending our state's resources in relation to corrections. We want to make sure that we have space and resources available to incarcerate the most dangerous criminals and those who truly pose a threat to public safety. And at the same time, we want to make sure that we're using good use of our resources to prevent those low-risk, non-violent offenders from becoming hardened criminals. So this will allow us to reinvest our appropriation in effective strategies that will ultimately produce better outcomes and reduce crime in the state of Oklahoma.
Speaker Steele, thank you.
Thank you very much.